Good afternoon, dear students. Today we are going to study our 18th lesson, The Management of the Welfare State of Swaraj, Part 1. I divided this lesson into two parts. So students, let's see the first part. Shivaji Maharaj struggled long against many unjustice power. They were the Adilshahi and the Mughals' power, the Portuguese and the Siddhis of Janjira. That is how an independent Hindu Swaraj was created. For smooth working, Shivaji Maharaj divided the administration into 8 departments. He appointed a minister in charge of each. This was his famous Council of the 8 Ministers. Swaraj of Shivaji Maharaj was state-run for the welfare of the people, in the true sense of the terms. It was run with the assistance of the 8 ministers. Shivaji Maharaj himself made the appointment of these 8 ministers and their others appointment officers, the basis of the eligibility and merit. He supervised all their work. Do you know, food, clothing, shelter are the basic necessity of life. In a welfare state, these needs of people are satisfied. Women are honored. Common people, peasants, are not devised. Injustice is not done to anyone. Justice is dissipated quickly. Agriculture and industries develop well. Folk art flourish. People can live a happy, contented life. People live happily in the Swaraj created by Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. Therefore, the qualities of confidence, self-respect and patriotism struggle emerge among the people of Maharashtra. The Council of 8 Ministers. Name of the minister, designation and department. First come More Trimbak Pingle. Designation, Pradhan. Department, administration, political. Second, Ramchandra Neelkanth Majumdar. Designation, Amatya. Department, revenue. Of environment given in the textbook in a big and beautiful letters and make a chart. Read it loud in the classroom or you can read it at home loudly. Students, natural environment include the land in nature. Also, factors like air, rain, rivers and streams, sea, forest, the birds, animals, light received from the sun, etc. It is beneficial for man. Make us make use of this environment only to meet his necessity. Shivaji Maharaj took precautions to avoid the distractions of this environment. Factors. Shivaji Maharaj saw to it that the forest in the kingdom could not be destroyed by the people. From the royal edict, we can see that he had issued many orders like the following. For the navy, it is necessary to build boats and ships for various size and the beams, mast, or etc., for which wood is required. To obtain this wood, only teak tree should be cut. If more teak tree is required, it should be purchased from foreign territories. But no one account could should a mango, jackfruit, or other tree be cut. They don't grow in a year or two. People look after them like their own children in the order of growing them. Cutting them is to inflict sorrow on the people. It should not be cut. Even when a tree is greatly worn out, it should be cut only after paying the owner and getting his consent. Always remember, World Environment Day is celebrated every year on 5th June to emphasize the importance of conserving and protecting the environment. Water management. Shivaji Maharaj had various bunds built near the village in Swaraj to make drinking water available to the people. Canals were dug out to make water available for agriculture. Due to this, there was an increase in the produce. People in Swaraj never felt that severity of drought. During the reign of Shivaji Maharaj, the number of people living on fort was quite large. Shivaji Maharaj took care to make proper arrangement for water on the forts. Before building a fort, the place was inspected to see whether enough water was available there. In case it didn't have water, the tanks and reservoirs were built there before the onset. The rainy season and rainwater was stored in them. Do you know the government has started the project Jal Yukt Shivir to make Maharashtra a drought-free state? The stored water was used economically. Due to such water management, people on the fort and other subjects in Swaraj did not suffer for shortage of water even during the drought period. Drought relief. Shivaji Maharaj gave various facilities to drought-affected patients. He used to waive tax, so the severity of drought was reduced for people in Swaraj. In a drought year, Shivaji Maharaj distributed the grains stored in the state grains free of cost to the people. He also undertook repair of various forts and construct of dams, burns and canal during drought year. This way, the peasants and artisans or velveteers could earn their daily living and did not feel the severity of drought. As the peasant became wealthy, he could afford to buy things like footwear, clothes, etc. This provided work to the artisans. Those who never were homeless till then developed the capacity to build their own house. This in turn provided work to the masand, the carpenters, and the blacksmith and the brickmakers. This is how, along with the peasants in Swaraj, artisans also become happy and wealthy. Sea trade and other markets. Shivaji Maharaj raised his own independent navy in order to protect his Swaraj well and to establish his rule over the sea adjoining Swaraj. But that was not all. He also had special cargo ship built to promote trades in Swaraj. He developed the trade forts like Rajapura. He also built a special market on Raigad. He started a separate marketplace at Khed Shivapura near Pune. He developed marketplace in a big town and roadside villages. A new pet or settlement was established at Pashan near Pune by the order of Veer Mata Jijabai. It was referred as Jijapura. Shivaji Maharaj levied more tax on goods imported from the outside region to promote the trades within Swaraj. He levied more tax on the salt produced in the Portuguese territory, which made in coastal area. On the other hand, he reduced the tax on the salt produced in Swaraj so that the people could buy it at a cheaper rate. Naturally, he led to an increase in the trades of the salt produced in Swaraj. Those local trades was encouraged. Shivaji Maharaj made efforts for the growth of the trades and industries in Swaraj. He personally made sure that his subject could not be cheated by the merchants in any way. When he came to know that people were being cheated in the account and betelnut trades in Konkan, he warned the subedar of that region. Both students will see the remaining part in next lesson. Thank you.